Hello people, welcome to Geeks to Geeks. In this video, we'll be dealing with a customer segmentation dataset and performing k-means clustering to segregate customers based on the data in form of clusters. This is used in a variety of applications such as market segmentation, document clustering, and many more. After all, the goal is to get a meaningful intuition of the structure of data we are dealing with. So let's begin with the tutorial. In this problem, we'll be going under this process like understanding the data. Then we'll perform elbow method to find the optimal number of clusters. Then we'll train a model using unsupervised learning algorithm, that is k-means. And finally, we'll plot the clusters and gain the intuitions from them. Coming towards understanding the data, in this section, we'll be importing some useful libraries followed by reading our data. We will understand our data and find if any null values exist in our data set. And finally, prepare a subdata for our clustering purpose. So we'll be starting off this code by importing some important libraries, such as importing pandas as pd, importing numpy as np. Sorry, it should be import. Then import matplotlib. And import seaborn. So basically, pandas is mainly used for data analysis. Panda allows importing the data from various file formats such as CSV files, JSON, SQL, Microsoft Excel. Pandas allows various data manipulation operations such as merging, reshaping, selecting, as well as the data cleaning, and many more. While NumPy is a basic level external library in Python used for complex mathematical operations, while matplotlib and seaborn are amazing data visualization libraries which we'll be using to plot our elbow plots and clusters as well. Now we'll start importing our data. So basically for this tutorial, we'll be using mall customers data, which is readily available on Kaggle. We'll import the data using df, which will be our variable in which we'll save our CSV file, pd.readcsv. Since we are importing a CSV file, we'll mention CSV here, else if the file is in Excel format, we'll read pd.readExcel and the file path in which we have saved our file, mallcustomers.csv. Now, when we hit df.head, this will display the top 5 rows. Now, if for example, if we want to display the top bottom rows, we will write df.tail and it will be giving the last 5 rows. Now, we can mention the amount of rows we want to display. For example, if I want to display 10 rows, so I'll mention df.head 10 over here and we can get the top 10 rows over here. So let's first understand about our data. So we have customer ID, which is unique for each of the customer. We have gender, age, annual income, which is in $1,000, and the spending score, which ranges from 1 to 100. So if basically a customer is spending less amount of his salary or income, the spending score will be on lower side and vice versa. Now, in order to see the shape of our data set, we'll execute df.shape. And we can see that the output is 200,5, which means we have 200 rows and 5 columns. Now we will execute df.info. So this command basically displays a brief information about our data, which include the not null count, that is if there are any null values or not, the data type, what is the type of our features, whether they are integers, float values or categorical values, etc. And finally, the memory usage of our data. So let's execute the command. And we can see that firstly, we don't have any null values in our data set. We can see except gender column, all other columns have integer values, while gender is categorical feature having object values. And also we can see that the memory usage is just 7.9 KBs. Now, as we are dealing with the unsupervised learning approach, here we will be plotting our clusters of customers based on the factors such as annual income and spending score. So what we'll do is create a separate data frame X, and we'll execute X is equal to df dot iloc semicolon and 3 and 4 dot values. So Panda provides us a unique method to retrieve the rows from the data frame. The data frame iloc method is used to extract the column based on the index number. Here df.iloc 3, 4 represents extracting column numbers 3 and 4 and saving them in our new data frame, which is X. And now when we execute X, we'll be getting values of our annual income, which is our third column, and spending score, the fourth column, in form of arrays. As we are done with the first part, that is understanding the data and preparing the data for clustering, that is we separated the columns such as annual income and spending score in order to use them for customer segmentation. Now we'll be coming towards the second step, that is performing elbow method to find the optimal number of clusters. In this step, we'll be using k-means to iterate from 1 to 11 clusters and plotting an elbow plot out of it, and decide the optimal number of clusters to be used for our customer segmentation. Before starting, let's understand what is elbow method and k-means. So basically, elbow method is fundamental step for any unsupervised learning algorithm to determine the optimal number of clusters into which the data may be clustered. Also, it's one of the most popular method to determine its optimal value of k. When we plot the line chart, it resembles an arm and the elbow. That is the point of inflection on a curve, which is a good indication that the underlying model fits best at that point, which is optimal number of clusters. Coming towards k-mean algorithm, k-mean clustering is an unsupervised learning algorithm which groups the unlabeled data set into different clusters. Here the letter k defines the number of predefined clusters that need to be created in the process. As if k is equal to 2, there will be 2 clusters, and for k is equal to 3, there will be 3 clusters, and so on. It allows us to cluster the data into different groups and convenient way to discover the categories of groups in the unlabeled dataset on its own without any need of training. We'll be starting off by importing k-means from sklearn.cluster. So from sklearn.cluster import k-mean, and also we'll be creating a blank list, say WCSS, and we'll execute this. Now for each value of k, we are calculating WCSS, which stands for within cluster sum of square. WCSS is a sum of square distance between each point and the centroid in a cluster. When we plot the WCSS with the k value, the plot looks like an elbow. As the number of cluster increases, the WCSS value will start to decrease. WCSS value is largest when k is equal to 1. Now, we will be using a loop to find out the optimal value of k using an elbow method. Now for that particular purpose, we'll be using this static code. Basically, this iterates the k-mean algorithm for our data for I iterations from 1 to 11. Since we assume that maximum clusters possible would not be more than 10. Here we are using initializer as k-means++. This means k-means++ algorithm ensures a smarter initialization of the centroids and improves the quality of clustering. Basically, k-mean++ is a standard k-means algorithm coupled with a smarter initialization of centroids. In this code, k-means inertia is a formula used to segregate the data points into clusters. Now it's time to display our elbow plot, and how can we do it? So we'll be using matplotlib. So we'll be executing plt.plot range, 1 to 11, WCSS. Now we'll be also adding the title to our plot, plt.title that is the elbow method. You can change it as you want. Also, we'll add the X labels and Y labels, which will name the X label as number of clusters and Y label as WCSS values. And finally, we'll be executing plt.show. Now, after executing, we can see a plot has been displayed. Now, here we can see that the plot reduces drastically from cluster number 1 to cluster number 3, slows down till 5, and flattens from 6 to 10. We can see that we are getting an elbow at k is equal to 5, which means finally the optimal number of clusters can be assigned as 5. So no matter what range we select, say if we select a range from 1 to 21, we'll see the same behavior. Once we are done performing the elbow method to find the optimal number of clusters, we'll be moving towards the next section, which is training a model using unsupervised learning algorithm, which is k-means. So here we'll be initializing our k-means model with a selected optimal number of clusters, and we'll plot the clusters and gain intuition regarding our customer segmentation. Now, once we have got the optimal number of clusters, which is 5, we'll start building our model now. So we'll create a variable k-means model is equal to k-means, where n clusters will be assigned as 5, then init, that is initializer, will be k-means++ as we explained before, and random state will be equal to 0. Now, once we are done initializing our model, it's time to use this model for making our predictions. So how can we do that? So k means is equal to k means model dot fit predict and our data x. So x is our data, which includes the salary, annual salary, and the spending score, and we'll be saving these predictions into a separate variable yk means. So let's execute this. Now, once we are done storing these predictions in yk means, it's time to plot all our clusters. So here we'll be using scatterplot for that purpose. So I have written the code already for plotting our first cluster. So here plt.scatter means the scatterplot. Then we'll feed the sparse matrix of our outputs, that is x, which is our data, and the k means 0, 0. And k means 0,1 represents the matrix of output cluster. S represents the size of clusters. You can change it as you wish, and we'll mention the color as well. So for first cluster, I've given the color red, and label as customer number 1. So we'll just copy this line of code for all the 5 clusters we have generated. So we'll be giving customer number 2, customer number 3, customer 4, and customer number 5 for each of the unique clusters. And also we'll be giving unique color such as blue, we have yellow, we have can, and we have black. And also we'll be changing these coordinates such as 1, 0, and 1, 1. Here it will be 2, 0, 3, 0, and 4, 0. While here it will be 2, 1, 3, 1, and 4, 1. Now, apart from plotting these scatter plots to display our all 5 clusters, to make it more informative, I'll be also adding the code for plotting the cluster centers, that is centroids of clusters. So basically here, the cluster center will plot the centroids for each of the cluster present, And also we'll mention the size as 100, which is a bit larger than the normal clusters. And color will be magenta, and we'll label these as centroids. We'll be also adding plt.title as clusters of customers, plt.xlabel as annual income, and ylabel as our spending score. We'll be also adding the legend in our plot, and finally we'll be displaying the plot by executing plt.show. As you can see, a beautiful plot has been displayed. So what are the intuitions we can extract from this plot? We can see that a blue cluster on the top left side represents the customers having comparatively less salary, but their spending is quite high. On the other side, we have black cluster, which represents customers whose annual salary is quite high, but their spending is comparatively less. Now for any company, the people from this red cluster are the target audience, since the maximum people are included in this red cluster. Also, they have decent salary and their spending is also quite well. So the company will promote their products more with the customers included in the red cluster than the customers included in other clusters. Well, this is the most important intuition which is extracted by a lot of companies to target their customers based on the available data. But yeah, the practical data will be a lot more complex, but the basic principle of clustering remains the same. Well, this was all from my side, and thank you so much for watching the video.